Level 9001, The Unsettling Thoughts. Survival difficulty, class variable. Varying safety, heavily unstable, diverse entity count. Level 9001 is the 9002nd level of the Backrooms. When level 9001 was first discovered, the level resembled a seemingly normal neighborhood that consisted of houses that looked almost identical to each other and a long circular road. Though the houses weren't completely useless, as they contained some important resources like almond water and moth jelly, even though there weren't any death moths spotted living there. The main twist of this level is that it's most likely that you'll never see the same thing as other wanderers did when they entered this level, as this level generates what kind of adventure you'll be going through by reading your most recent thoughts, meaning that if you thought about something before entering this level, it'll most likely turn your thoughts into an actual level. Thought of a dark, scary level with barely any lights? Here it is, specifically made for you. Everything can vary depending on your thoughts. Everything, and we mean everything. The level's appearance, survival difficulty, entities, etc. You'll never be on the same level, and of course, people can't meet each other as everyone has their own revisions. Even if the revision seems to be good enough to be habitable in and possible to make outposts in. Survival class difficulty? 0. Safe, secure, devoid of entities. The first and most well-known revision of the level is, well, a long circular road with houses that contain important resources inside of them and is completely devoid of entities. The insides of the houses could vary from different things, for example, furniture being upside down, having no gravity at all, being completely empty, etc. This revision has no day or night cycle and is always evening. The Wanderer also stated that it could rain in this revision and also stated that the water drops were actually almond water. Survival difficulty? Bending. Undetermined safety, unsecure, unknown entity count. The second revision of the level resembled a library with an extremely weird appearance because it felt distorted, broken, and uncanny. The library also had thousands and thousands of various books containing various bits of information, for example, backrooms entities and level information, common biological and geographic information, and etc. The revision also had the infamous buzzing lights similar to level 0's buzzing lights, but in this revision, they were much louder. Not much is known about this revision other than the information listed above. Survival difficulty, class 4. Unsafe, unsecure, high entity count. The fifth revision of this level resembled the Wanderer's home, but it was infested with entities such as skin stealers, death rats, and death moths. According to the Wanderer, the water was swamped with liquid paint, meaning taking a bath or trying to get water from the taps was pretty much impossible. The Wanderer didn't make it out alive. As for the revision's appearance, the revision had two floors, a basement, a kitchen, a living room, two bedrooms, and an attic. The attic, as stated by the Wanderer, was the safest part of the house. Other than the entities and liquid pain, this revision was nothing special or unusual. Survival difficulty, class 2. Unsafe, secure, low entity count. The sixth revision of this level resembled a typical school, which didn't have anything groundbreaking or interesting. The only thing which was different from the normal front room schools was that the ways of how to enter several levels of the back rooms were written on the whiteboards, and there were actually entities in this revision, which were death rats, adult facelings, and child facelings. Adult facelings were the teachers, janitors, principals, etc., and child facelings were the students. This revision, as stated by the Wanderer, was completely safe to live in, as the facelings were completely friendly. Survival difficulty class? 1. Safe, secure, minimal entity count. The seventh and currently the last documented revision of this level resembled an airport with entities such as adult facelings and child facelings. Though unlike their normal behavior, adult and child facelings here acted like normal humans, meaning they aren't aggressive until you provoke them. This revision is the only revision to be confirmed to have an actual exit, as stated by the Wanderer of this revision. You could also get tickets here to levels such as level 2885, level 3999, level 9, etc. Though it is unknown what happens after the plane starts to fly up, as the Wanderer passed out when the plane started flying up, and after waking up, the Wanderer ended up on level 2885. This is the only known person to successfully escape the level. Entrances and exits. Entrances. The first way to enter this level is by randomly teleporting here. You'll never know when you entered this level, though if you think about the front rooms are pretty much nothing, you won't be sent to this level. Exits. There are currently no known exits and most likely will never be because, as mentioned earlier, everyone just has their version of this level. It is advised to just wander around your revision, trying to find the exit.